If you've ever thought about moving your website, stop before you make any more decisions and make sure to watch this video. Whether you're just adjusting your domain from one to another, or you're completely moving your site from one platform to another, there are a couple steps that you need to take in order to make sure that it doesn't tank your SEO in the process. I've done this twice in my own business. When I first started the business in 2013, I started as casebolt creative.com, and then I moved over, I rebranded into megaboltdigital.com, and then in March of 2020, I moved the site completely over to Love It First Search and rebranded the entire business. Every time I did that, I saw my SEO take a hit because I was making these adjustments to where I wanted people to find me. No matter how well you prepare for this, moving your website or changing your domain will have an impact on your SEO. But there are steps that you can take in order to mitigate that disruption. It's sort of like moving in real life. You go to the post office and you fill out that change of address form that says, you used to send my mail here, now I want you to send my mail here. And it only takes about 5 minutes and you get all these coupons and it's really great. But then you also have to call the cable company and close out your water bill and hire your movers and pack the boxes. And oh my God, just thinking about moving makes me sweat a little bit. Oh, it's so terrible. But thankfully, moving your website doesn't have to be as labor intensive as moving your house, and you probably won't throw out your back doing it. So stick with me and I'll walk you through three scenarios and how you can make sure that you're not seeing a huge dip in your SEO when you move right after this. Hi, I'm Meg Casebolt, the founder of Love It First Search, where we help online businesses to show up in search results and then turn those new visitors into leads, subscribers, and sales. If you've been running your business for a while and you've had an established website for a while, you may want to find a way to update your website, to find a new home for your website, or to completely move your website from one platform to another. But if you have been around for a while, then you have some established SEO domain authority on whatever your domain is. After all, your domain is basically the way of telling the internet where your home is. And so when you move, you have to go through and re-update all of those places and let them know where your new location is. And that's not just for your entire site. It's like a page-by-page assessment, potentially. So let's walk through three different scenarios that you could be going through where you might need to make some specific adjustments to the way that you're thinking about your website before you move it, and then the changes that you need to make. The first scenario is that you're only moving your domain. Maybe you bought a domain to start your website and it wasn't the best domain, and you decide you want to move to somewhere else, but the whole website is staying the same. So for a while, when I was Casebolt Creative, I thought about just moving my domain over to Meg Casebolt. It would have been just as easy to have it there. People would have remembered my name. I owned the domain already. I still own the domain. If I had wanted to do that, nothing would have had to change on the website. I just would have had to say to Google, I used to be at Casebolt Creative. Now I want you to send all my traffic to megcasebolt.com. This is the least disruptive option that you have, especially if you're keeping the same logo and the same brand name and the same platform that you're built on. There may be a really good reason for this change for you. Maybe you just got married, mazel tov, and you just want to change your domain, but all of your offers are the same, you're on the same platform, you just need to change your last name in the same way that you send all that paperwork into the state. You're also going to move your domain from one place to another. So there are three things that I want you to do before you change anything in your domain settings, your DNS settings, however technical I want to get with you here. And those three things are, number one, go into your Google Search Console and figure out how much of your traffic is branded search terms. When I say branded search terms, I mean, what's your name? What's your business's name? What's your product's name? What are things that people are already looking for you because they know you? The number one source of traffic to my website is people looking for Love It First Search because they know that that's the name of my business and they just don't know exactly what the address is. So they go to Google, they search for it, they find me. If I were to move away from the Love It First Search brand, then I would potentially lose a lot of that traffic because I would no longer be ranking for that term with my domain. That's not to say it would be a bad decision depending on where I'm going, but I would want to know just how much of that traffic was coming from my brand name. if you have a lot of branded search traffic coming to your website, then you want to make sure to continue to integrate that phrase of your old business into some of your content on your website. So when my business made the adjustment from being Megavolt Digital to being Love at First Search, I had a blog post specifically there called Megavolt Digital is now Love at First Search. And I added the permalink that had Megavolt Digital in there so that way Google knew that when people were looking for the term Megavolt Digital, they would still find that page on my site and go to the right place. And then I could tell them about the decision and why we changed the brand name and why we moved the domain. And I wasn't going to lose that branded search. Step two, find and fix all of the broken links on your site. Have you ever clicked on a link and seen that like error 404, page not found? That link is broken, meaning that that page no longer lives where it used to. And Google hates broken links. It makes your site look unreliable. So before you change anything about your page, make sure that it's nice and tight, that it doesn't have a bunch of broken links, because we're about to redirect from one URL to another URL. And if we have also a bunch of redirections and broken links and all the things going on, then it just makes Google feel like they're on a pirate treasure map to nowhere. So you want to get everything cleaned up as much as possible before you move any of your domain settings. Also, this is a good time to check out and see what Google knows about your existing site. You can go right into the Google search results, type in site, S-I-T-E colon, and then your domain name, and it will show you all of the pages on your site that it sees. And that can be a really good way to get an idea of what has already been indexed by Google and what might need to be adjusted or moved. Take a look at how many search results there are, because after you move the domain of the site, within a day or two, you're gonna wanna do that exact same exercise again and make sure that all of those pages got redirected. We don't want some pages to be moved and some pages to be in the old place and kind of just be confusing. We want everything to move all at once. The actual process of changing your domain is not all that difficult. The way that you do it may be different based on where your domain is hosted, you know, but with most WordPress pages, you can go into your cPanel, you can set up a parked domain. You know what? Just hire a developer, because I'm not going to tell you about HT access and all those pieces of things. I have a bunch of developers that I will absolutely recommend in the bottom of this post in the description. So when you're ready to make these changes, hire somebody to do it for you, please, because it's kind of a pain in the ass. And then also make sure that Google knows about this change. So after you've moved your domain, after you've changed your domain settings and your website's on the new location, go into Google Search Console, verify your new domain, and then there's a setting called the change of address that you have right there in Google Search Console. It's kind of hard to find because it's very rare to be used, but you can just say, here's my old domain, here's my new domain, zoop. And hopefully it will make sure that Google knows that everything from the old location will go to the new location. Now, that was the easiest scenario. What if you're not just moving from one domain to another, you got married and now you're just changing your domain name, but you're also redesigning the site and reimagining what you want your business to be? A couple years ago, when we rebranded from Megavolt Digital to Love at First Search, this is the process we were going through. We were going full speed ahead into only SEO, no web design involved. So we were also rewriting all of those pages, redoing all of our visual assets, really just the entire thing got blown up and reconstructed, but we also knew that we had a lot of really good assets on the old site and things that were already ranking for search terms that we didn't want to lose traction on. So the first piece of advice I have for you when you're redesigning your website is please do it all at once. Don't like piecemeal things together and start moving a couple things over and just move the key pages and then like 2 months later move over the blog, because what that's gonna do is split your traffic and split your domain authority between these two places and weaken your old website and have a new weak website that gets launched. Instead, what I want you to do is create a staging site where you can build out everything you want the new website to look like and import all of those old pages into the staging site and then push it live all at once. This isn't a piecemeal process. It really needs to be done as a launch all at once. We built the entire Love at First Search site as a staging site, so the old site never had to be like, under construction, please check later. Instead, we just one day, I think it was March 1st, 2020, tough time to launch something, turns out, who knew? We pushed everything live and then sent out an email and went, hey, look, come check out our new website. Number two, before you actually launch that new website, I want you to go in and take a look at all of the search terms that you're ranking for on the old site. So not just what are the pages, but what are the specific things that you're ranking for on a page by page basis. And if you're rewriting some of that copy for your new site, make sure to integrate those keywords. If you have a keyword that you're ranking for that you're not getting a ton of traction for, you may want to emphasize it in the new writing of that page. Or if you have a keyword that you're ranking really well for and you don't want to lose the traction that you have on that keyword, make sure to continue to include it on that page and really emphasize it in that way. So making sure that you go through and figure out what your existing keywords are and map them to the pages of the site that you're going to be rewriting so you don't lose any traction. And you might see a little dip, but you might actually pick up more steam when you relaunch the website, which can be a really cool thing to see. Step three, if you're redesigning your website, is to map out any structural changes that you're going to make. So if you have offers that you're retiring or new ones that you're creating, you want to make sure that any traffic that's going to that retired offer will have a new place on the new website that you can send people. And then you want to go through and set up a 301 redirect to take people from the old offer to the new offer, or the old page that explains something to the new one that you've rewritten. And then when that new website is ready, you can push it live and then go through all of the steps from the domain transfer. So make sure that the new site is brand new, ready, live, perfect, and then you can adjust the domain at that point. All right, the third scenario is, what if you want to move from one software tool to another software tool? Quick disclaimer, I'm going to discourage you from doing this if at all possible. If you're on WordPress or Squarespace or Shopify, which are my three favorite platforms for SEO, don't jump ship without a really good reason to jump ship. There's no perfect solution. There's no out-of-the-box option that will be everything that you need it to be. There may be ways that you can improve what's happening on your existing website without needing to move to a totally new platform. Maybe you want to try a different theme or hire a specialist to make some updates instead of blaming the platform and trying to jump ship. You may take some of those problems with you that you're trying to resolve, and then you'll also have to deal with all of these problems. But if you feel very strongly that you want to move locations, if you're tired of the plugin updates and you want an easier solution, or if you're selling more e-commerce and you want to have an e-commerce built-in platform like Shopify, okay, there are times when it does make sense to move. If that's the case for you, here are some things to think about. Follow all the same things that I talked about for a site migration. So mapping out all of the keywords that you have by page, thinking about if you're restructuring anything, where you need those keywords to go and what pages will be replaced by new pages and how you want to set that up. Apparently this hand gesture is happening a lot this time. Step two. Look at the way that your permalinks are structured. Let's say that you're on WordPress and you go into your reading settings. There are a couple different ways you can structure your blog permalink. Sometimes you include the month or the day in the actual location of the file. Sometimes you have a category in there. Sometimes it just is the blog title. You can set up how you want that to be. On other platforms like Squarespace or Shopify, there are specific ways that they structure those things. So all Squarespace blog pages usually start with /blog, and then they have the information in there. That's the default setting there. So you don't want to move everything over and not set up those redirects to go from, you know, just the title of the post to /blog/title. They would basically all be seen as brand new pages, and it would look like all of your blogs are 404 errors. So you want to make sure that you understand how those permalinks are structured. Talk to the person who's making these changes for you, talk to your developer, and make sure that they know where all of these different permalink changes are going to happen. You can usually do this site-wide where you just say, change all the permalinks from this to this, but it is a line of code that needs to go in there. So don't forget that. Otherwise you might lose all the traction you have to that area. Or let's say that you have an e-commerce website and right now you have it on WooCommerce through WordPress and you want to move it over to Shopify. And right now your shop is in a subdirectory called products and Shopify calls that subdirectory collections. You don't have to go through and set up individual redirects that every single product you're going to have to rewrite it. There are ways that your developer can just say every permalink that has the word product in it, let's just call it collections now. So this doesn't have to be a time consuming piece, but it is something that you want to be thinking about as you're making these major changes. All right, step three is to migrate over all of your content. Depending on how much content you have, if you have a lot of products or a portfolio or a whole lot of blog posts or podcast show notes, you may be able to use a tool like CMS to CMS, which would export all of your content and import it into your new location. And then you, at that point, would have to probably redesign all of those pages, or at least all of those templates, because the way that one site codes things is completely different than the way another software is going to code things. But please make sure to export and import that information rather than just copying and pasting it, because sometimes a lot of extra code happens at that point and it can make the site really clumsy and bloated. And also make sure that all of your images move over from your media library, because sometimes if you export the content without exporting the images, then you're gonna have to go through and re-upload all of those anyway, which is kind of a nightmare. And step four, if there are pages that you don't want to bring along with you, that's okay. You can purge them. If part of the reason that you're moving sites is because you've completely reinvented the way that your business runs, that's okay. You can get rid of some of those, but don't burn it all to the ground without a plan. If you have a page that you want to completely delete from your site that is getting some search traffic, make sure to set up a 301 redirect from that page to a new page that you want that traffic to go through. If you have pages that, like, you don't even need to have them exist anymore and they're not getting any traffic, you or your developer can set up what's called a 410 redirect, which is just a way of saying, Google, we got rid of this page. You don't have to try to find it anymore. It's gone forever. But you don't want to have it just kind of be out in the ether. You want to tell Google that it doesn't exist in that case. Now, as you can see, renaming or redirecting or migrating your website is a really big commitment, and it's not something that you want to take lightly. So if you're going to go through this process, be sure to hire an expert. If you're about to move and you need help with your migration, making sure that all of your keywords are mapping to the new locations, definitely reach out to us at loveitfirstsearch.com. We can hop on a call and figure out if there are ways that we can work with you and your developer to mitigate that process to make it as smooth as possible. And we'll also list a link to developers that we work with so that you can check in with somebody, make sure that you're getting everything that you need in order to make that change work for you, so you don't see a huge drop in your traffic. Please like this video if you thought it was helpful, and subscribe to the channel for more tips about how to make sure that your SEO is bringing you amazing clients, even if you're moving. Because moving is a nightmare no matter what. See you next week.